From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Shannon Moss.
And I'm Erin O'Valley. Hearings begin today on Capitol Hill for President Obama's 2012 budget proposal. The president has called the cuts that he is proposing painful.
There is one that is hitting home here in Maine, a 49% reduction in LIHEAP funds. It's federal money that helps thousands of Mainers heat their homes. News 8's Dave Guthrow has more.
Well, if proposed cuts go through, Maine would receive less than $27 million a year under the new LIHEAP figures. That's down from the current level of $56 million. Maine Senators Olympia Snowe and Susan Collins have already come out and publicly said that they oppose this bill. Now, Maine received applications from over 70,000 people seeking heating assistance this year, and that number increases each and every year. So certainly cutting the budget in half is something that could drastically impact many, many Mainers as we move forward. Now, again, these are just proposed cuts, and the numbers involved could drastically change as time goes on here and as Congress argues about annual spending bills in the coming days and weeks and months. And, of course, we'll have the latest developments on News 8 and on WMTW.com as we proceed. For now, in Portland, I'm Dave Guthrow for News 8 Now.
Well, the man police say stole computers from a Portland school is due in court today for a hearing to change his plea. 31-year-old Brian Berry of Portland is charged with burglary and theft in connection to the case of 78 computers stolen from the new Ocean Avenue school. Berry turned himself in after detectives found 61 of the stolen computers in Berry's apartment during a search back in November. When they were taken, the computers worth more than $70,000 were still in boxes and being stored in a separate area while contractors continued construction on that school.
Portland police have launched a new website to help you keep track of crime in your neighborhood. You can access the site from the department's Facebook page. It maps all the police incidents in the last 2 years, and it tells you the date, the street, and the violation that occurred. Portland police hope knowing more about what's happening in their neighborhood will help people be more attentive of their surroundings and report suspicious activity. Also helps the department keep track of the incidents so they can focus more on higher crime areas.
This helps the officers on the street who may not have much interaction with a crime analyst. It helps them see exactly where the crimes are occurring in their area so they can be more proactive and more focused.
Now, this is a look at the site. Right now, Portland police have a year-long trial subscription, so the site is free for you to check out. We have a link in the Ask CNN section of our website. That's WMTW.com.
Well, a young Iraqi girl who underwent several surgeries here in Maine is headed back home.
Before boarding their plane yesterday, Nora Abdul Hamid and her father spent time with friends at the Portland Jetport, friends who they have come to know very well throughout the years. Nora first came to Portland in 2008 for life-saving medical attention. Her skull was shattered by U.S. sniper fire back in 2006. Since then, she's undergone 14 surgeries and had her final stitches removed just last week. Nora and her father say they are grateful for all of the help that they have received while they have been here in Maine. And thanks for tuning into this News 8 Now update. I'm Erin O'Valley.
And I'm Shannon Moss. Stay with us to bring the latest forecasts and sports highlights in just a few minutes. We'll be right back. We'll be right back.